Yes, class here, please look. And poster making, I have told you, it is what is the purpose of writing a poster? It's conveying a message. Okay, so posters, as we all of you take out your notebooks, please. Take out your notebooks. We'll be continuing in the chapter. Let me just tell you what you've done in your test. See, I just don't want to understand why you, Mansi, stand up. Stand up. Go in the end. Get up. Last bench. Last bench. I don't know who is the bigger fool, you or he. The whole day he's been attending the class and he's been attending without a pen. Go over there. Last bench and remain standing. Anybody else who does not know how to behave, you remain standing. What are you, uncivilized people? You've escaped from the forest or somewhere. You are tribals. And tribals are better. Let's not, typify something. You people have become tribals staying at home. You've lost all connection with civilization and now you don't know what to do in this new environment. As I discussed with you all, posters, they are first and foremost importance is there to convey a social message, right? About any social issue, anything that is important to the society. Like we had done about saving water, saving electricity, say no to drugs, right? Follow traffic rules and right, save the girl child, all these here, okay? Then we have like about some kind of instructions or warning, like we're talking about crackers here, Diwali is around the corner, giving directions regarding that. Talking about, yes, nowadays, as we're reading in the newspaper, the number of cases here, dengue rising, and what the things you are supposed to do and not to do, okay? So giving warning and instructions. Okay. So leave it like that only. So you can keep it when the period is over, then you can distribute. Not now. Keep it in your bag. Keep these there. Now, yes, here. Yeah. Like you can have a poster which is giving instructions, telling people that in this kind of a situation, that is here when the dengue cases are increasing, what is it that you're supposed to do, right? So telling the people that, yes, you should not let water to collect, right? And yes, wearing full sleeves clothes and keeping your legs covered. And of course, yes, using your mosquito repellent. So main is maintaining cleanliness, right? Then, yes, you have about a public event. Now it was about an art exhibition, which is for a social cause. So we have people there, they're holding exhibitions, and the money which is collected, it goes towards some kind of charity, right? Towards some kind of organization. So you had to write that. The art exhibition, right? So maybe it could be a renowned painter putting up his paintings. And the proceeds of that would be going for a social cause, right? It was not that you had to come and paint over there and you had to put up your painting. No. Yes, do you want to go to class 2 or 3? Even those students know how to behave better than you. And Ramnik, I told you to change your seat. Do you understand English? I don't care whether you have a book or no book. Sit down, Nancy. So yes, so public event, right? It is there just like a poster. You are giving information about the event which is going to take place, right? It was about an art exhibition. So come and donate for a noble cause. The renowned painter showcases talent, and the money collected would be for, you can say, you can pick up any charity which you would like to, you know, talk about, right? Yes. So whether it is for the environment or for, you know, cleaning the rivers, or it is for the girl child, or it is for the general upliftment of the weaker section of society, right? So any kind of noble cause, you can write that. Here, when we do a public event, what are we going to add here? See, it is not a notice. It is a little bit of a notice with more information. Presented how? Visually, right? So presented in a manner that makes it more attractive and appealing. So yes, after you have given your heading and you made here you will give the date, time, venue. And yes, what is the entry like? Yes, it's a ticket. Where are the tickets available? Where can you collect the passes? All that has to be mentioned. Now, similarly, on these lines, it could be that maybe your school is organizing a play, right? For the welfare of slum children, right? So you've organized a play and you're going to that place to show it. And so what would that be? So who all can come and see? Who would like to participate? It could be that. Yes, so who can come and watch the play? And are there tickets to that? Yes, there are tickets, and you can buy the tickets and you can come to watch that play. So where is that money going to go? It is going to help the slum children, right? To get maybe a better school, to get more facilities, okay? So here we have about the event. If an event is there, we talk about date, time, and venue, okay? So give your heading over here. Give your content, so you can give a catchy tagline or something here. You are giving your visual inputs you can talk about. Here, what would it be? Yes. Time, venue, talk about the tickets, how are they available, where you can get them, and of course, yes, what about the money, what will go. And please, here I read a number of posters. It seems as if you just came to school and you never ever listened to what the teacher had to say, right? Whenever a test is conducted, it is more of my, evaluation than yours. How much you listen to the teacher. And when I see your test, before this also the test was so pathetic, this test equally bad. Now next time when you give the test, I want you to prepare well, study well, and then give the test. Don't take everything like a joke. Don't think that you've come here to the class just to fool around and all. I think so. It's been quite a number of months now. You've met your friends, right? They're all hale and hearty. Aren't they? Yes. And so are you. So now let's move to the next step. What's that? Let's focus on our studies. Are you doing that? No, we're not. Are we serious in any subject? No, never. What are we doing in the classroom? Fooling around. And now is that going to continue? Till infinity. For always. You have not realized that you have wasted more than 1.5 years of your life. Will you ever get the time back again? No. You have lost a lot. Yeah, you're very happy, fine. CBSE is so generous and we got so many marks and we are unable to, you know, bear that. Oh, we're still under the aftershocks of that result. How could I manage such a grand result? Let's come back to ground zero. Let's come back to reality. And the reality is now, the reality is what you people are doing in these tests. We'll find your artwork, don't worry. We'll put your artwork for sale, okay? Yes, so we're going to organize a charity event. Anybody who even understands that letter or poster, please take it away. Isn't it? Right? Okay? Okay, let identify your handwriting and take it back. Identify your handwriting and take it back, okay? That's the only I would say. Okay, then maybe it's not checked. So identify your test, that's it. Fine, is it clear now? Posters are clear. Letter was about, you know, disruption of public life because of religious or social reasons. And it happens a lot, you know, this is the beauty of our country there are so many festivals, there are so many reasons to celebrate, there are so many problems that we have. Sometimes we keep on celebrating, sometimes we keep on demonstrating, and we end up creating a problem for the public. And you have experienced it, how, you know, like, yes, traffic jams are caused, right? People have to wait endlessly. Okay, your whole schedule is thrown out of order, right? So you might have to reach some important place, it's delayed, and even the diversions and all you take there, what happens, right? So all this you have experienced. I think so it was quite an easy letter that you could have written. Fine, you people are there, smart enough, you have enough creativity. The only thing is, I don't know when you're going to bring that creativity out. Keep it hiding inside you. And it will remain a secret forever. Let's see your creativity. Right now, Purav is showing me how creative he is at keeping on talking endlessly. It is a talent I know that he has since I don't know how many years. Okay? We have recognized the talent of yours. And Aditya, oh my God, he is immensely talented at talking so much. So yesterday I have also discussed with you all the project that you people are supposed to do, right? So let's continue with the chapter. Yes, so Albert Einstein has found a solution to his problem. What is that? What is the solution to his problem? How is he going to leave the school? Yes, Kunal? By giving a medical certificate and by requesting the doctor to say that he has a nervous breakdown. Did he really have a nervous breakdown? No. And, you know, like, yes, he thinks that by the time I actually reached school, he was so nervous meeting the doctor. What did his friend warn him about the doctor? Yes. So he is going to be the first patient. What else did he tell him? What else did he tell him? Yes, Harleen, you can do your sleeping later on. I'd like to see a book. Where is it? Stand up. What do you come to school for? To laugh around, to play around? So, yes, his friend warns him that Yuri is a very smart doctor, so don't try to lie and tell him the truth, right? And Albert Einstein thinks that if I lie to him, I might not get the certificate, then I might not be able to leave school. So he's quite worried that if he has to come to school, he will definitely get a nervous breakdown. Okay. So now let's see here. I go to Italy, said Albert, to Milan, where my parents are. This is where we ended. So where is Milan? In Italy. Okay. Where was Albert Einstein? Which place was he? He was in Italy. Where's Munich? Yeah. So he was there. And what will you do there? Please look at your book. Silence, students. Silence. What will you do there? I'll try to get into an Italian college or institute. How can you without a diploma? You've not completed your schooling. How can you get admission anywhere? I'll ask my mathematics teacher to give me something about my work. And perhaps that will be enough. I've learned all the maths they teach at school and a bit more, he added when Dr. Wee looked doubtful. So he said, yes, my mathematics teacher might give me a reference that he is good at mathematics. And Harleen is standing there talking to others because she doesn't want to study herself and will disturb others also. You want to leave my class? Most welcome. Most welcome. Come here on the first bench. Well, it's up to you, he said. I doubt it if it will come off, but I can see you're not doing any yourself or anyone else much good by staying here. How long would you like me to say you should stay away from school? Would 6 months be all right? Now the doctor here is really understood and this boy wants to leave. And he has got a letter or a reference from his mathematics teacher. His mathematics teacher was the only teacher in the school who understood the genius of this man. Understood how bright this child was, right? And he's given him a letter that, see, I have taught him everything that I could. And he is now ready to go for further studies, right? So that is how he would get admission in a college over there in Milan. That is where he was planning to go. And yes, here, if you don't want to study, don't disturb others. It's nothing. I've only just stopped being a student myself. So I know how you feel. Here you are. Dr. Wheel handed him the certificate and the best of luck. How much? Nothing. If you have anything to spare, invite Yuri to a meal. He's a good friend of mine and yours too, I think. Albert had no money to spare, but he pretended he had and took Yuri out to supper. So the doctor did not take any fee. The only fee he asked for was that take Yuri out. And even though Albert did not have enough money, he took his friend Yuri out for a treat. Isn't it wonderful, he said after showing Yuri the certificate. Which certificate? Which certificate? Medical certificate, that if he stays here any longer, he would get a nervous breakdown. Yes, it's fine, Yuri agreed. 6 months is a good period. This way, you won't actually be leaving the school. So if the worst comes to the worst, you'll be able to come back and carry on your diploma. So for 6 months, if you're not able to settle down anywhere else, or you're not able to get admission anywhere else, you can always come back to the school, right? I'll never go back to that place, Albert assured him. I'm going to take the certificate to the head teacher tomorrow, and that will be the end of it. So tomorrow, I'm going to give the certificate and I'm leaving school. Don't forget to get a reference in writing from your mathematics teacher first, Yuri reminded him. Mr. Koch willingly gave Albert the reference he wanted. If I say I can't teach you anymore, and probably you'll soon be able to teach me, will that be all right? This is something so nice that his teacher said, that I can't teach you anymore, and maybe you are capable of teaching me. He appreciated, he understood the genius of this child, right? Others did not. That's saying too much, sir, said Albert. It's only the truth, but all right, I'll put it more seriously. It was still a glowing reference, and Mr. Koch made the point that Albert was ready immediately to enter a college or institute for the study of higher mathematics. And we have read, you know, children of a very young age, bright, very brilliant, and yes, able to grasp knowledge and concepts that are much beyond their age, right? So we have, yes, these are very few cases that we do come across, real child prodigies or geniuses. So his teacher said that, yes, you can go. And from my side, you know more than I do. I'm sorry you're leaving us, although you're wasting your time in my class, he said. It's almost only class where I'm not wasting my time, said Albert. But how did you know I'm leaving, sir? You wouldn't have asked me for this reference, of course. I thought you'd wonder. There's nothing to wonder about, Einstein. I knew you were going to leave before you knew yourself. Albert was puzzled. What did the teacher mean? The teacher knew that this child was intelligent enough, would not continue here, right? He was unhappy here, or was it something else? He soon found out. Before he had a chance to ask for an interview with the head teacher, he was summoned to the head's room. Otherwise, he would have to wait for his turn. Well, it saved me the trouble of having to wait an hour or two outside. He hardly bothered to wonder why he had been sent for. Otherwise, he started worrying that why has the principal called us? So the head teacher has called him. But vaguely suppose he was to be punished again for bad work and laziness. That means he's been punished before. He's been called before also, right? So maybe it's the same problem. Well, he had finished with punishments. He's going to show his certificate and he's leaving the school. I'm not going to punish you, the head teacher said to Albert's surprise. Your work is terrible and I am not prepared to have you here any longer. Einstein, I want you to leave the school now. Leave school now, repeated Albert, dazed. That is what I said. You mean, said Albert, that I am to be expelled? How did Albert want to leave the school? Nalin, stand up.
He wanted to show that he would have another double breakdown. If he continued in the school, then thus wanted to show that medical center.
He would not show the reference. That was for his admission. Yes, that was for his admission. So how did he want to leave? He wanted to tell the teacher, you know, like what the school system is doing to him. But before he got a chance, what happened? He got expelled, right? So because he was creating a problem because of his bad behavior, he was lazy, he was not doing his work. So what is there? The master said that you are leaving the school. Albert, but what crime have I committed? See, he wanted to leave, but when the principals told him to leave, then he is a little surprised at how. Your presence in the classroom makes it impossible for the teacher to teach and for the other pupils to learn. You refuse to learn. You are in constant rebellion and no serious work can be done while you are there. So even if one child is there disturbing the class, telling I don't want to do this, I can't understand this, and why are we learning this? How is it going to affect the other students? So they'll also wonder why are we doing this, right? What should have the teacher done in such a scenario? When Albert was saying again and again, you know, and he was there, it was not only one subject that he was creating a problem, he was creating a problem in all the classes. Then what should have been done? Does that mean, is our education system flexible to adjust to various needs? What could have been done to adapt or you can say accommodate Albert Einstein? Or to adjust to his needs. What could have been done? Anyone? Ananya? If you finish with your discussion, you can give the answer. No? Anyone? Navya? No? How can the school adjust? Supposing there are one or two students, right? Either they know too much, right? They're constantly disturbing the class. Not because, they don't know anything, but because they know everything, or they know a lot. No one knows everything. We always are there, as we said, we're constantly learning. But whatever the curriculum has to offer, how can the teacher handle such a student? How do we channelize that student? Yes. Make him the teacher. That's Kunal's solution. Then Vinayak said that. What else? What? So management mein bana do kaise, like what? So we can, yeah, give the child maybe extra work, extra assignment, something that is maybe a level higher, so that the child is occupied. No, then what should we do, Navya? Where does he belong? In the classroom? To another class? Don't take his exam. Okay, tell him to stay at home. Is that the solution? Then? Yes, Navya, please. Samriddhi, what? Megha? Send him home? No. Like she's also saying, absolutely correct. Yes, otherwise, we can give questions which really, make him learn more. Right? Say yes, Nalin. Promote, look at Ramik, what's this boy, Harsimar and Tishnu, busy in their own world. They don't care about what Einstein is doing or anybody can do or whatever they want to. We are happy right now having a gossip. I said Harsimar. Yes. So we can, of course, here. The child could be promoted. Yes? No? Not promoted even. Then what? Wahi theek hai. Bahar theek hai. Okay, let's finish these few lines. Aryan. Straight. Yes. I was, Albert filled the medical certificate almost burning a hole in his pocket. Burning a hole, it's making him very conscious. You know, he had come to give the certificate, but he's leaving away the certificate of expulsion. Then we are in agreement, at least Einstein, the head said. For a moment, Albert was tempted to tell the man what he thought of him and his school. Then he stopped himself. Without another word, holding his head high, he stalked out. Shut the door after you, shouted the head. Albert ignored him. So he says, now I'm not listening to you. He walked straight on out of the school where he had spent 5 miserable years. And 5 years is a long time to suffer. So, without turning his head to give it a last look, he could not think of anyone he wanted to say goodbye to. He did not like anyone in the school to say, or meet the last time. Indeed, Yuri was almost the only person in Munich he felt like seeing before he left the town he had come to hate almost as much as the school. Elsa was back in Berlin and he had no other real friends. Goodbye and good luck, said Yuri when he left. You are going to a wonderful country. I think, I hope you will be happier there. Thank you.